It's my great pleasure to welcome you to this course TSFS03 Vehicle Propulsion Systems that treats conventional, hybrid and electric powertrains. And we'll look at modeling, control and optimization of these types of powertrains. This introduction will be about the course and its teaching. And my name is Lars Eriksson and I'm a professor at Vehicular Systems and I've been working with energy efficiency all my professional life. Coming to the contents now, we will go through the teaching elements, the lectures, the Q&A sessions, the project, and what you will use as your main source of information. So first about lectures, since we're in distance mode, I guess you're getting pretty used to it by now. All teaching in this course is in distance mode, so we will unfortunately not have an opportunity to interact in person and discuss in person, but we have to do our best and work with Zoom. The lectures will follow the lecture schedule as it's in your schedule on time edit. The lecture principle is that we have pre-recorded videos. There will be 2 or 3 videos per lecture, usually 2, sometimes 3. The lengths of the videos vary in the range of about 14 minutes to 40 minutes, and the total lecture time is usually less than 60 minutes for each lecture. The lecture videos will be released 15 minutes before the scheduled lecture start, and you can find them on the YouTube channel Lars Lectures, and there it is under the TSFS03 playlist. To support you in the learning process, we have Q&A sessions, and the thinking is that if you get a question while you're viewing a video, then pause the video, write down the question, and if the question still remains after the lecture, then bring it to the Q&A session. About lecturing and interaction in distance mode, the Q&A sessions start 1.5 hours after the scheduled lecture start. That is 15 minutes before the lecture ends in the schedule. And I will be available in a Zoom link that is available on Lisa. In that Zoom room, I will wait 15 minutes for you to show up. And if no one shows up and asks questions, then I leave. But if you show up, then I will answer your questions and comments and give some additional material that might come from questions that you have posed and that has sparked your interest in something. If we look at the lecture on Monday, there is a lecture planned 10:15 to 12. The flow will be as follows. At 10 sharp, the first video is released on YouTube. At 10:15, the second video is released. And at 11:45, I will be in the Zoom room, ready for your questions. Concerning the project assignments and the support in this distance mode teaching, you can work on your assignments anytime. The lab sessions that you find in the schedule, they are to be seen as support sessions, where teaching assistants will be available, but only in the Zoom room. So participate in these sessions to get help and also listen in on your peers' queries. You can also share screen to get better help during the process. There are computer rooms booked in the schedule, but they are only booked for those that don't have their own computer to do the hand-in assignment, so that we shouldn't exclude those from completing the course. But the rooms will not have any assistance. The assistance will only be available in Zoom due to the distance requirement. Over the project time, you can ask questions on any project in the course. And in the process, it's good if you raise your hand so that we can take your questions in order. And if you're too shy to ask your question, you can write privately to the assistant in the Zoom room. And if the question is easy or of a general nature, then the assistant might answer it directly by reading the question and providing the answer without disclosing your identity. If there is need for more details in the question, you can go out to a separate breakout room and get help there. Your sources of information is Lisa, and there you will have the links to the Zoom rooms, and you will have the places where we will work with the hand-in assignments, in terms of that you're handing in the assignments there and we're iterating the corrections and following up your examination. And we'll also use that as a communication about the issues and course information for you during the time. While the traditional homepage, there we are keeping things that are more or less the same from year to year, with modifications in terms of how the course evolves. But we are using the course homepage with the things that are connected to the content of the course, in terms of lecture slides, and in terms of hand-in assignments, and also help for the hand-in assignments. So you will hopefully spend most of the time searching for information there, and then you will go to LISAM to finish the reports and follow up on the reports. Just concluding remarks now, welcome to the course. I'm really happy that you have shown interest in this dynamic area of sustainable transportation and electromobility. And there are a lot of things happening right now in society, and you will have many opportunities to contribute to the development as engineers. And I'm looking forward to interacting with you during the lecture Q&A sessions and also giving you a set of toolboxes for your future engineering work. And together, we will create a sustainable future. So once again, welcome to the course. Looking forward to seeing you. Bye-bye for now.